Hi, I'm Jay Sellers with the Brunswick-Glynn Joint Water and Sewer Commission. Let's spend a few minutes together diving deeper into how our water distribution system works to protect your health by learning a little about backflow prevention. Our backflow prevention program outlines the technologies and methods that are used to ensure that the water that you drink is not contaminated or polluted by foreign objects, hazardous chemicals, or unpleasant substances that can make their way into our drinking water distribution system from someone else's point of use. If no protections existed, water that is cycled through cooling systems in large buildings becomes a breeding ground for bacteria as the water heats up. Water in fire suppression systems often sit stagnant for years and even decades if there is no fire, making the water stale and undrinkable. Chemicals used in manufacturing processes could make their way into your drinking water if the pressure gets higher within the factory than the pressure on our system. Plus, since water likes to take the path of least resistance, a main break caused by materials failure or construction damage could cause this undesirable and often undrinkable water to be siphoned into our distribution system and possibly into your glass of ice-cold water. Thankfully, these protections do exist. Our system has just short of 30,000 service connections. The majority of those could be considered to be low-risk connections. You likely don't use any chemicals or pumps that are directly connected to the water distribution network. About 2,500 connections can be considered medium risk. The pollutants you would be exposed to wouldn't necessarily make you sick, but they wouldn't give you confidence that the water is safe to drink either. Around 1,500 of our connections are medium high to high risk, meaning that the process used by the facility could expose you to contaminants that could likely make you sick. Two major types of backflow exist: back pressure and back siphonage. If some type of pumping system within a building causes the water pressure to increase above our static system pressure around 60 psi, the water will make an attempt to find relief downstream, often taking with it any dangerous chemical that is connected to the system. This is known as back pressure. Any connection on the system could get this contamination until the system pressure has been equalized and the chemical flushed out. If your neighbor has a pest control business and fills up their pump truck without using the most basic protection known as an air gap, and pressure drops downstream due to a large fire being put out or a main break, the chemicals in this pump truck tank can then be pulled into the system by a situation known as back siphonage. Any point of connection from the truck to the source of the pressure drop could be contaminated. We actively review plans for new construction and building remodels to ensure that all connections have a device known as a backflow preventer, which is designed to reduce our exposure to these hazards to a degree that matches the risk. Any testable device then requires annual inspection. Ideally, every connection would have the type of device that is designed for the highest rating. However, since that would be financially unrealistic for the customer and introduce very high costs for annual inspection and administration of the program, we require the following devices on our connections depending on the hazard. For low-risk connections, such as your house meter, we require a simple non-testable dual check valve device that gets installed with a new meter and replaced when the meter is upgraded, usually every 10 years or so. Buildings with fire suppression systems, houses that have an irrigation system with chemical injection pumps, or pools with autofill and auto-treatment often get labeled as medium risk and have a testable device installed, such as this double check valve assembly. High-risk facilities typically use a device known as an RPZ or reduced pressure zone backflow preventer. This device dumps water to the ground if the pressure inside the building gets higher than our system pressure or if the pressure drops below it, like in the case of a water main break. This type of device has to be installed above ground to work correctly, which is why you often see them popping up on the side of the road. We require annual certification of all testable devices and require the installation of an appropriate device if a facility's change of use indicates an increase in hazard. This backflow prevention program is just one of the many ways that we work hard to ensure that your water is the highest possible quality for you and your family. Every day, the staff of the JWSC is here to serve you.